The previous example provided an intuitive explanation of why the RM algorithm can converge. Now we will give a more rigorous mathematical description, which is this theorem. This part will be more mathematical. If you are not interested, you can skip it. However, this part includes many interesting concepts, such as certain conditions you will often encounter in future studies of temporal difference learning. Therefore, if you have time, I highly recommend studying this part. The theorem states that, under these conditions, the RM algorithm ensures that WK will converge to W star, where W star is the solution to GW equals zero. When we talk about convergence in this context, we refer to it as with probability 1, abbreviated as WP1. In many reinforcement learning papers, proofs often mention with probability 1. Why? Because WK is not an ordinary number. It involves sampling a random variable. Thus, its convergence is not in the conventional sense, but in the probabilistic sense. You can refer to the appendix of my book for more information on this topic. Let's have a look at the three conditions. The first condition is about the gradient of GW. The second condition is about the coefficient AK. The third condition relates to eta, which is the measurement error. Next, I explain the three conditions. First, the gradient of GW must be greater than a constant C1. What does this mean? If G and W are scalars, this is a derivative. The condition requires that the derivative of the curve must be positive, meaning the curve must be monotonically increasing. If the curve is monotonically increasing, the solution to GW equals zero exists and is unique, as the curve will intersect the zero line at one point. Second, the gradient must be less than a positive constant, meaning its gradient is bounded from above. It avoids the situation where the curve may at some point have an infinite gradient. If such a situation occurs, the algorithm might diverge gradually. Another condition about GW is that it must be increasing. Some may argue that this condition is too strong. In fact, this condition is mild. Why? Recall our earlier discussion on an optimization problem, where the goal is to minimize an objective function. The optimization problem can be transformed into solving the equation GW equals zero, where GW is the gradient. When we require that the gradient of GW be greater than C1, we actually require the second derivative of the objective function, or the Hessian matrix, to be positive definite. A positive definite Hessian matrix means that the objective function is convex. Therefore, this property corresponds to convexity, making it a mild condition. The second condition is about the coefficient AK and is further divided into two subconditions. The first subcondition states that the sum of AK should be infinite. The second subcondition states that the sum of the squares of AK should be less than infinite. First, let's examine the condition that the sum of the squares of AK should be less than infinite. What does it mean? If AK does not eventually approach zero, and if it remains greater than or equal to a very small number, like 0.001. No matter how small it is, as long as it is a constant, the sum of infinitely many AK will eventually diverge to infinity. So what does this condition imply? It implies that AK must eventually converge to zero. The other condition, that the sum of AK equals infinity, implies that AK should not converge to zero too fast. For example, if AK converges to zero within two steps and remains zero afterward, the sum would not be infinite. The third condition is about eta. The first part states that the mean of eta should be zero. The second part states that its variance should be bounded. A common scenario is that eta is independent and identically distributed, which satisfies these conditions. In addition, the observation error eta is not required to be Gaussian. Let's further discuss the second condition because you will often encounter it when reading papers or books. I will provide a detailed explanation. These two subconditions are not as difficult as they might seem at first glance. First, let us look at the first condition, which is that the sum of the squares of AK should be less than infinite. We previously mentioned that this condition essentially means that AK should eventually converge to zero. Why is this condition important? Let's rewrite the algorithm. The original algorithm is WK plus 1 equals WK minus this term. By moving WK from the right side of the equation to the left side becomes the difference between WK plus 1 and WK. If AK eventually approaches zero, it means that the right side will also approach zero. When G tilde is bounded, it will definitely tend towards zero. This property is necessary because we hope WK to eventually converge. In the long run, the difference between WK plus 1 and WK should ideally stop fluctuating. The second condition is that the sum of AK should be infinite. We mentioned earlier that this condition means that AK should not converge to zero too fast. Why is this condition important? Let's take a closer look. We write out the RM algorithm step by step. For k equals 1, we have W2 equals W1 minus a number. For k equals 2, we have W3 equals W2 minus a number, and so on. We can add up all the left sides of these equations, then add up all the right sides of the equations, and then cancel them out. Finally, we get this equation. You can derive this by yourself as an exercise. This equation essentially tells us that if WK converges in the end, it should converge to W star. The term W1 represents our initial guess. Therefore, the left side represents the difference between W star and W1. The right side is a sum. If AK's sum is bounded and G tilde is bounded, then this right side term will also be bounded. This means that the difference between W star and W1 is bounded. That means we cannot choose W1 arbitrarily far from W star. So this condition allows us to safely choose W1, regardless of how far it is from W star, ensuring convergence. A question that naturally follows is what kind of AK can satisfy these two conditions? One answer is that AK equals 1 over K. We mentioned this in the mean estimation example. Why does it satisfy these two conditions? First, there is a mathematical conclusion that the sum of 1 over k from k equals 1 to n minus natural logarithm of n approaches a constant as n approaches infinity. Since natural logarithm of n approaches infinity, we know that the sum of 1 over k from k equals 1 to infinity is infinite. Another mathematical conclusion is that the sum of 1 over k squared from k equals 1 to infinity is a constant. These are basic conclusions from the number theory. More information is given in my book. In summary, 1 over k satisfies these two conditions. If any of the three conditions in the RM algorithm are not met, the algorithm may fail to work. Let's consider an example where GW equals W cubed minus 5. This example does not satisfy the condition that the gradient of GW should be bounded. Here, the gradient of GW is 3 times W squared. When W approaches infinity, this also approaches infinity, potentially causing the iteration to diverge. In practice, although 1 over k satisfies the conditions, we do not always set AK to 1 over k or let AK approach 0. Instead, we often choose a sufficiently small constant for AK. Why do we do this? Because if AK equals 1 over k, the impact of later data becomes very minimal when k is large. In real-world applications, the problems are often complex and we want future data to be useful. Therefore, we let AK be a very small number instead of converging to zero. Next, we apply the RM algorithm to the mean estimation problem. Do you remember this algorithm? It is the mean estimation algorithm we introduced at the beginning of this lecture. At that time, AK was set to 1 over K. If AK equals 1 over K, we can explicitly write out that WK plus 1 is indeed the average of KXI values. If AK is not 1 over K, we cannot write out such an explicit value. However, can we still prove that WK plus 1 will converge to EX? We left this question unanswered before, but now we can prove that this algorithm is a special case of the RM algorithm. Therefore, its convergence follows. Let's see why it is an RM algorithm. Consider this problem. We have a function GW, GW equals W minus EX, where EX is the expectation of a random variable, a constant. This is a simple function of W minus a constant. If we solve GW equals 0, we get W star equals EX, thereby obtaining the expectation of X. Although we do not know this expectation, we can sample X. Thus, what we measure is G tilde, which equals W minus X, where X is a sample of X. We can rewrite G tilde as GW plus an error eta. To break this down, G tilde equals W minus X. Adding and subtracting EX gives us W minus X plus EX minus EX. Then we combine these two terms, merging W minus EX, and this term is actually GW. Then we combine these two terms, which is EX minus X, and this term is eta. EX is the quantity we are seeking, and eta is a measured error. So, what is the corresponding RM algorithm? The RM algorithm is this. Substituting the specific value of G tilde gives us WK minus XK. This is the mean estimation algorithm we previously described. Therefore, the mean estimation algorithm is an RM algorithm. According to the properties of RM algorithms, if alpha k satisfies the conditions of its square sum being finite and its sum being infinite, the algorithm will converge. Next, we introduce a more complex theorem, which is optional to study. Let's quickly go over this theorem. This theorem covers the convergence proof of a more complex stochastic sequence. We have discussed the RM theorem but have not proven it. The RM theorem can be proven using this theorem, which can also be used to directly analyze the mean estimation problem. An extension of it can be used to analyze Q-learning and TD-learning algorithms that we will discuss later. This is for those who are particularly interested or who have the capacity to delve deeper. If you are not interested, you can skip this part. If you are interested, more information is available in my book.